scenes from the lush surroundings and unmistakably grand streets of Vichy in the heart of the Auvergne in France. A spa resort which once attracted upmarket tourists from across France and beyond, its grandeur recently provided a somewhat fitting backdrop to the oldest air sports event in the world, the Gordon Bennett Cup. A race for gas balloons first held in 1906 and now celebrating its 58th running. Marcus Hageneyer of the FAI, the governing body of air sports, sets the scene.
Really pleased to be here in Vichy. It's actually the Gordon Bennett 58th time. It's the oldest race in aviation. First launched in 1906 by famous US newspaper tycoon. The race technology in the early days was very much as we see today, basically a balloon envelope filled with gas. You had ballast to throw out to get lift and go on as long as you could. And James Gordon Bennett had the idea to do this spectacular event to raise the distribution of his newspaper. The winner in a Gordon Bennett race is the pilot achieving the longest distance in a straight line. So the longest flight ever was flown by a Belgian pilot, Bob Berman, from Albuquerque in New Mexico to Canada, 3,300 kilometers. The longest endurance was a German pilot, Willy Eimers, flying more than 92 hours from Switzerland to the Baltics. So there were lots of records achieved during the Gordon Bennett.
So a race which has witnessed many a milestone in aviation history. None bigger, though, than the achievements of this man, Brian Jones, who in 1999 circumnavigated the globe uninterrupted in just short of 20 days.
So inside of our balloon, we had a standard gas balloon, which was full of helium, which is exactly the same as the balloons flying in the Gordon Bennett. But then in order to fly for really long distances or for long periods of time, a normal gas balloon that you fly in the Gordon Bennett can only fly for about 4 days because you have to drop ballast. Hydrogen contracts at night and the balloon wants to come down, so you throw out sand or water, ballast, to keep the balloon in the air. Well, you can only do that until your ballast is gone. Whereas if you put a fire or a hot air balloon mixture underneath a helium cell, then you get a balloon called a rosière, which was the one that we flew around the world.
Well, the Gordon Bennett crews reliant solely on ballast and gas. The former carried mainly in the form of numerous small bags of sand, while the gas in this instance is hydrogen, a cheaper and sustainable alternative to helium, which has become the lifting gas of choice. Those are the constants. The variables, of course, are weather dependent.
So today we had a lot of rain in the morning, but our weatherman says it will stop at 9 Zulu, which is 11 o'clock local here. And it stops right, he said. And everything, now it's a little bit dusty and everything is dry. And it will clear up more and more. And during the night we will have clear sky. And the weather forecast is that for the night we have good conditions to fly, very low winds. In the morning they will climb up above the heating up of the lifting gas. And then we go up and fly to Italy. And in northern Italy, we expect thunderstorms, but it depends how it works there and how big the low pressure is there.
Tough conditions ahead then, demanding much of the crews and their support teams. None, however, had the Gordon Bennett experience of duration record holder Willy Eimers of Germany.
My first race was 1985, and then my break a little bit, and I beginning new 1992, and then continue with today. This is my Gordon Bennett race 2024. The next year 25, and I think that is finished. 25 is a good time, and that is a lot of work. It is a lot of money. We are all on all the 3 days no sleep. It's a hard work. I win the race 3 times. You win not for you. You win for your country. That's the problem. I win 3 times, but I lose a lot of race. I 8 times. Second place, and the second place is the first loser.
Piloting France 2 is first timer Eric De Silieris, who's been fortunate enough to come under the wing of 8 times winner Vincent Lees.
I do hot air balloon since 24 years, but I just started gas ballooning 5 years ago, like my co-pilot Hervé. We had our best pilot in the world, Vincent Lees, who was our instructor, and he told us how to fly, how to keep the spirit, how to perform the balloon. There are a Met guy, ATC clearance guy, and then a routing guy who is doing trajectories and proposing different options. But these guys are our eyes, because we are piloting the balloon, but they say there is thunderstorm here, you shouldn't go there. There is some rain here, but it's not very dangerous. Or there is clear weather here, but very gusty. They said that they will make a final decision about the strategy with us, probably 7 or 8 p.m. tonight, at the last minute, because the models will be very, very precise.
So with the launch planned for 10 p.m. and conditions over Vichy slowly improving, crews and ground teams began the inflation process and final preparations for the hopefully long flight ahead. Of launch approach, we asked the crew of USA 2 whether they'd finalized their own plan of attack.
Well, each pilot tries to develop a strategy to win. As you know, the Gordon Bennett is who can fly the furthest distance. Sometimes the weather on the lower winds will be going one direction, maybe slower, and then you can go up to 12,000, 15,000 and go maybe 40 miles an hour in a different direction. So you plan your strategy to get the longest distance, also avoiding obstacles, airspaces, mountain ranges, and weather.
Strategy is changing hourly. It's this is a very difficult one. And it's difficult that we're going to have to fly with weather to the north of us, and there's going to be weather to the south in Italy. So it looks like at this time we're going to try to hit the middle of Italy somewhere.
Kurt Frieden, winner of the event in 2010, was also weighing the many and varied options this year's event could offer.
Here is it jetzt schön. Wir haben das, der Regen ist vorbei.
It's not straightforward this year, the weather. At the moment here, it's beautiful, the rain has passed. But the areas we're traveling over, they'll have rain again. So we may have to land earlier or later. As I said, it's just not straightforward. One option is to go high, between 4 and 5,000 meters. But then you rise quickly and you hit the poorer weather earlier. If you go further south, Yugoslavia is closed. You can't land there. You can only travel over it, so that's not simple. Whether you'd have the time to be able to get to Romania remains in doubt. With darkness having fallen and crews pretty much ready to go, reigning title holder Vincent Leys appeared quietly confident. We've put a huge amount of effort into getting the machine ready in its current state. It's technically very advanced, and Christophe is finalizing preparations right down to the very last detail. And so, with clear skies above and light winds, 17 balloons and 34 pilots from 7 different countries took to the air as the 58th Gordon Bennett Cup officially started. Gordon Bennett underway, the next few days at the launch site in Vichy were not, however, going to be uneventful, as 32 balloons and their crews converged on the city and its surrounding countryside to battle it out for the prestige of becoming the second annual FAI Hot Air Balloon Junior World Champion. Very much contrasting event to the Gordon Bennett's, as British Chief Observer Joe Slade explained.
Well, the whole point of competition ballooning is all about accuracy of flight. So the pilots are flying to a point that's either set out on the ground, which will be a target in a field, or they're flying to a point that's set in the sky. Well, the most challenging thing really is when they go out on a morning flight and they've got six tasks to do. And so they have to fly to two different points in the ground, three different points in the sky. Then they've got to think of their own goal for the next task. So before they've thrown a marker on the ground, they're thinking, where am I going to fly to next? So the complication really comes in the combination of all those tasks between flying to points in the sky and then flying to points on the ground where they're throwing their markers.
The people are amazing, they're so nice, everyone's really friendly, everyone's pretty much happy to help out, which is nice, but well, as soon as you're in the air, it's more competitive, but fantastic, good, great organisation as well.
I did this competition 2 years ago and it was not so high level, and now it's higher and higher, so it's really great for all junior pilots. It means that the future of hot air balloon is here, and I'm very glad for that.
Nowadays, the age doesn't mean anything. We're going to more technologic flight modes and so on, computers, GPSs. You have only pluses if you are younger. So the level is like normal world championship.
There are pilots who are very good, who's got over 400 hours. So that's a lot of experience for their age. And junior means up to 27 years of age. So that's also, it's not that young as it sounds.
If you have a good flight, there are normally five tasks in a morning flight. If you do well on all five tasks, you'll move up. And if you're in the top 10, you'll probably be challenging for the lead at the end of the flight. And if you have a bad flight, you can drop very quickly. So, I mean, yeah, like any sport, things can change quickly.
Very quickly indeed. In fact, the lead had changed more than once through the duration of the championships, and on the last day, with just one flight and two tasks remaining, Rokas Kostakovicius was just holding off the challenge of Dom Barraford of the UK in second and Clement Seagal in third. One small slip and the win could go either of three ways, and tricky launch conditions really did throw the cat among the pigeons on the last day. Eventually, however, it was British pilot 21-year-old Dom Barraford who took the win, just from under the nose of the reigning champion, Rokas Kostakovicius.